In this video, we're going to go over the two types of chemical bonds that you'll see in your first year chemistry course. So those two types of bonds being ionic bonds and covalent bonds. We're going to go over how those bonds get formed, how to tell them apart, and also how to predict ionic formulas. So let's start with covalent bonds. Covalent bonds are formed when two atoms share their electrons with one another. So for example, if we had two fluorine atoms that each had their own spare electron, those two electrons could essentially be shared between both fluorines. So what would happen is both of those electrons would be part of fluorine 1 and part of fluorine 2 as well. And the way that we tend to draw this is by drawing a single line between the two atoms to depict two electrons. So every time there's one line, that means there's two electrons. So for example, we can also have bonds that share four electrons. So we would draw that with two single lines like this. So this oxygen and oxygen shares four electrons between the two of the oxygens. And similarly, we can also do the same thing with three pairs of electrons. So in the case of these two nitrogens bonding, what we have is six electrons being shared between the two nitrogens. So these are single bonds for one pair of electron being shared, double bond for two pairs of electrons being shared, and a triple bond for three pairs of electrons being shared. Meanwhile, ionic bonds don't share electrons, but the electrons are still pretty important in ionic bonding because these bonds require charged atoms to be present. So we call these charged atoms ions, and they happen when an atom has either lost or gained an electron to have a positive or negative charge. So a positively charged ion is called a cation. So that could be, for example, something like sodium plus. This has lost one electron from neutral sodium to have a charge. And a negatively charged ion is called an anion. And an anion, for example, Cl minus, is an atom that has gained an electron. So now it has a negative charge. So an ionic bond happens when we have a cation and an anion together because opposites attract each other. So the positive charge and the negative charge pull each other together, and this pull is called Coulombic attraction. So essentially these will pull together to make NaCl, and that is what makes the ionic bond. So since the charges attract each other, they should be opposite but equal. So if we have, for example, a 2 plus charge, like Mg2 plus, we need two negative charges to balance it out. So that could be, for example, O2 minus. Or we could also pair it with two negative charges that are only a negative one. So for example, a Cl minus and another Cl minus. Either way, it's just important that we have the same amount of positive charge as we have negative charge in our ionic bond. So if you're not sure how to make the molecular formula from two ions with different charges, we can try something called the crossover method. So how the crossover method works is that, let's say we have two different ions that we want to put together to make an ionic bond. So let's say, for example, we have aluminum 3 plus and sulfur 2 minus. They don't have the same charge. So we can't just make it a 1-to-1 ratio of aluminum to sulfur because those charges are opposite but not equal. So what we can do is cross over the charges to become the subscript of the opposite ion. So what that's going to look like is aluminum will get the 2 from the sulfur, so we'll have Al2, and sulfur will get the 3 from the aluminum. So our formula would be Al2S3 in that case. Another example would be how earlier we had Mg2+ with Cl-. And we saw that we needed to have 2 Cl- in order to balance with the Mg2+. We can also use the crossover method for this. The 2 goes with the chlorine, and the 1 for just the 1 minus charge goes with the magnesium. So we end up with MgCl2 by that crossover method. So now that we've established the difference between covalent and ionic bonds, let's go over how to tell them apart. So molecules are usually written as chemical formulas, so you often won't see the lines to indicate covalent bonds or the charges to indicate ionic bonds. So what can we look for instead? The best tell is looking at the atoms involved and seeing if they're metals or nonmetals. Covalent bonds will usually be made up of only nonmetals. So things that appear on the right side of the periodic table. So for example, if we see a molecule like CO2 and we're trying to determine if that has ionic or covalent bonds, we can look at the fact that carbon and oxygen are both nonmetals. So that's a nonmetal. And this is also a nonmetal. So that tells us that this is probably a covalent bond that forms in between these atoms. Meanwhile, ionic molecules usually have a metal and a nonmetal. And the key word there is usually, so there are exceptions to this. But first I'll kind of show an example of the kind of typical ionic bond, which is a metal and nonmetal. So that would be something that looks like calcium fluoride, for example. So calcium is a metal, where fluorine is a nonmetal. And the metal will always be the cation, so the positive charge, and the nonmetal will always be the anion, so the negative charge. So if you see a metal and a nonmetal bonded together, it's generally pretty safe to say that this is an ionic bond in between the two atoms. However, I did say before that it's usually a metal and a nonmetal, but it's possible for you to have only nonmetals in an ionically bonded molecule. So it gets tricky when we have polyatomic ions. So those are, for example, CO3 2-, NH4+, OH-, SO4 2-. Those are just some examples, and you'll find that in your first year chemistry textbook, there will be a list of a whole bunch of the common polyatomic ions that you need to know about. These can make things tricky because, for example, let's say we use NH4+. We could have an ionically bonded molecule that looks like NH4Cl. Nitrogen, hydrogen, and chlorine are all nonmetals, but this is an ionically bonded molecule because this is NH4+ and Cl-, and those two groups are held together by Coulombic attraction of the two ions. What's most interesting about a molecule like NH4Cl is that the NH4+ and Cl- are ionically bonded, but the N and the H within NH4 are actually covalently bonded. So the entire molecule of NH4Cl has a combination of both ionic and covalent bonding. So there you have it. as long as you can recognize these polyatomic ions, you should be able to distinguish between ionic and covalent bonding for any molecule that you see in your first year chemistry course.